Hello! In this video, I'm going to show how to get started with Cubiclesoft PHP App Server to create lightweight, installable applications written in HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and PHP for the Windows, Mac, and Linux desktop operating systems. At the end of this video, I will have started creating a real software application and made fully functional installers for Windows, Mac, and Linux. Feel free to follow along. The first step is to obtain a copy of PHP App Server. I've already downloaded and extracted the latest version of the software. When using git clone, be sure to create a fork and a separate branch for your app before beginning development. Doing so avoids accidentally overwriting your changes whenever you fetch upstream updates for PHP App Server. Let's start by looking at the project's directory structure. First up is the www directory. This is where the standard web server files will go for the application. Next is the support directory. This directory contains all of the files needed by server.php. Server.php is the core of the product, which I will be running shortly. Next is the server extensions directory. This is where long-running processes, high-performance APIs, and WebSocket interfaces can be created. And finally, the secret sauce that brings everything together, the installers directory. This is where we'll eventually wind up to prepare the various application installers. PHP App Server is actually a fully featured and extensible web server written in PHP with WebSocket support, virtual directory support, dual document routes, access and error logging, and much more without having to mess around with any configuration files. Creating a quick information dump script called index.php and copying it to api.php in the www directory allows for experimenting with the server right away. Since I already have PHP installed in my development machine, I'll see what options are available by running php server.php --? There are quite a few options, but for quick development purposes, I can set what port to start the server on from the command line by running php server.php port 9002. Here we can see the output at various URLs that confirm that the web server works out of the box and is indeed processing PHP. If you are following along on your own computer, feel free to pause the video and try various URLs to see what sorts of things are possible. I'm going to use Cubiclesoft Admin Pack as the basis of the application and place it into www. You can, of course, use whatever software or framework you prefer. Next, I'm going to quickly create a little application that displays a few values specific to PHP App Server and the associated directory structures. Okay, the app is ready. Let's start building the final package, which I'll uncreatively call Basic Info 1.0. To avoid the risk of upgrades to PHP App Server overwriting my files, I'll rename files that start with your app to Basic Info. For a real software product, I would also make my own app icon, but the icon that is included is good enough as a placeholder. Now it is time to build real installers. PHP App Server comes with two pre-made boilerplate installer scripts for Windows, one for Mac, and one for Linux. There are readme.md files in each installer directory that cover the required steps to successfully create each installation package. When building installers for Windows, start in the win-inno-setup directory. Setting up the first build for Windows is the most involved process out of all of the packagers. This process also produces the largest installers due to needing to specially package and distribute PHP for the platform. First, load up the PHP Win32 and/or PHP Win64 directories with the version of PHP for Windows binaries that are known to work with the application. An application only needs to include the extension DLLs that it actually uses. Create and adjust php.ini as necessary. Once everything looks good, run the prepare-php batch file on a Windows box or a Windows virtual machine to prepare the binaries for release. InnoSetup is required to build the actual installer package, so be sure to install the latest release of InnoSetup. Next, rename and double-click the ISS file to launch the InnoSetup compiler script editor. Make changes to the various defines at the top of the file. Save it. And then run the compiler. Finally, test the generated installer package. And run the newly installed application. The first installer is done. Let's move on to the second installer, located in the WinWix directory. Install the latest release of the Wix toolset from wixtoolset.org. Next, rename the WXS file and edit the file using a text editor. Again, adjust the various defines at the top of the file. Run uuidgen-C to generate a GUID for the upgrade GUID define. Once done, save the file. Finally, run build.bat or build_64.bat depending on whether or not the InnoSetup-based installer we just created only runs as a 64-bit installer. A deployable MSI file is output. Finally, verify that the generated installer package works. The second installer is done. Let's move on to the third installer packager located in the nix-tar-gz directory. Edit the php nix-install.sh file located in the install support directory and add any necessary php extensions to the list. I recommend using virtual machines with various Linux distros set up to figure out what packages need to be installed for the application to work. In the main nix-tar-gz directory, rename and then edit the JSON file. Once again, adjust the various values. To prepare the installer, I'll transfer my application to an Ubuntu Linux virtual machine. And run php package.php from there. A tar-gzipped file is output. Test the installer package by extracting the tar-gzipped file somewhere. Then run install.sh or sudo install.sh to install the application. And finally run the newly installed application. The third installer is done. Let's move on to the last installer package located in the OSX tar-gz directory. Rename and edit the JSON file. Again, adjust the various values and save the file. Run php package.php and another tar gzipped file is output specifically for OS X. test the generated installer package on Mac OS X, and run the application. This concludes this intro video on building installable applications with PHP App Server. I'm looking forward to seeing what applications everyone builds with this nifty software solution. Be sure to like and subscribe, and thank you for watching.